Well, guys, it's home time. And gonna leave that old man up here again. And I'm just doing a bit of packing because, you know, I just woke up. I actually was so sick last night. Oh man, I woke up, like I was dreaming, I was in a dream and I woke up, and as I woke up, throw up was about to come out of my mouth and I went, and stopped it all. And then, yeah, I went to the toilet and I didn't throw up at all again. But yeah, I was sick, sick as a dog. I thought it might have been something that I ate last night. So,
or somebody you ate.
Oh, somebody I ate, what? So I leaned in to see if Mark was breathing. Couldn't hear him, so I woke him up. I was like,
I heard that.
I was like,
I heard that talking last night. I'm like, what the hell are you doing?
No, I just needed to tell him that I wasn't feeling well. And I just wanted to make sure he was not feeling well either. Like, just to make sure it wasn't anything that we did eat.
Yeah. Well, you ate something different, although you had a mouth.
He had a little bit of mine. Yeah, so I'm just gonna put you guys hang on that. That light. And just pack up whatever else I got. Alright, where's this tent? actually, I'm going to take this jumper off now because I'm hot. Bloody hell. Oh man, nothing wants to stay right at the moment. Oh, just put that up there for a minute. And that. Come on. Took that into that. Shit. Time for a coffee. I'll have Mark put the thing in. I'm gonna let you put the thing in. I've already wrapped it up and that stuff. Ugh. I'm gonna have a coffee. Oh man. Okay, coffee time. Coffee time. There's enough water in the phone cup. You know, the water, before the leak, did it come up harder?
Nah, there's a blockage.
Oh.
That's why we've got to get pumped in.
Right.
Yeah, and the pressure's bad in here, at the front tap, it's fine.
Right.
The gallon pipes that are mainly coming from that, they're all rusty inside.
Oh, shit.
So they're thinner.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, the pressure's pretty bad. The hose is hopeless.
Because, I was under the shower going, when's it going to go on me?
And you just hot water on, it's really hot. You turn the cold on just a little bit, it goes cold.
Well, I put the hot on quite a bit, and then I put the cold on, like just one cycle, and then I just edged it back a little bit until it got to my temperature.
It certainly is a bad mixture. It had the pressure. And that's what we've got, that's what we're riding up now for them to do.
Right. Because how do you make suds with that pressure? These people are probably going, how many teaspoons of coffee are you having? 2.5. 2.5 teaspoons. That equals about 1 scoop of one. And they're probably like, why aren't you having any sugar? Because I'm already sweet enough. Oh, where are my glasses at?
Oh, fuck, I'm looking on top of the car.
I just put that in the top. So I wasn't thinking. You know, and I even said, oh, don't forget about your glasses on top of car. Jesus. No puppies. Well, don't, oh, Jesus. I almost dropped my coffee. Oh, I want to show you how bent my glasses frames are. Look on top of the car. Check this, how bent my glasses are. I don't know if you can see that. Can you even see that? Anyway.
No.
They are bent.
Move. Back.
Bent.
Back.
Bella. Stop being a nuisance.
It's like we're taking back more things.
So, I just want to tell you a story about a guy. He used to live here. His name was Jeffrey. And Jeffrey died in this shed. I don't know exactly where he died. I have a feeling, but he died somewhere in this shed. And I think he was like working on something, like working on his car or whatever, or machinery or woodwork or something like that. And I think he died doing something he loved. So go Jeffrey. I've actually said, like, you know, you guys know I'm a very spiritual person. I even came in here the other day. I brought some sage incense to cleanse the place. The place feels nothing like, there's nothing here, but I still did say, you know, hey Jeffrey, you're allowed to stay here, blah blah blah. This is your home as much as ours, blah blah blah, all that sort of stuff. So I was like,
what did you just push through? Oh, my pillows. That's alright.
So yeah. It's really, how weird is this, right, Mark? You know how when I usually go and sleep at somewhere where it's new, and I usually have that automatic, oh my god, I wake up because something scared me?
Yeah.
Didn't happen here.
Good.
So, no ghosts. No ghosts.
Maybe if you'd slept in the shed, Jeffrey would
have. Yeah, I don't know about Jeffrey. I don't think Jeffrey's around much anymore. I think Jeffrey might come and go, but I don't know. I don't feel anything here. I don't. And my friends, a lot of my friends know when I feel something, there is something. And there is just, I don't feel anything here. Even though I did say, Jeffrey, if you are still around, blah, 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 blah. You don't have to let me know, but you're welcome.
Yeah.
So. It'd be nice to have a friendly ghost for a change instead of the one that I have that follows me around, which isn't here. So, well, actually, that's a good thing. He usually follows me around a lot. So if he's not here, then something else might be here that's protecting me from him. Maybe. I don't know. I'm just rambling now. And, I don't know. I'll use this, definitely. Yeah. So, did I tell you guys about the medium I went to? I'm pretty sure I did. I can't remember. I actually finally went to see a medium. And, she was spot on with everything. Like, she does know me a little bit, but she doesn't know me, like, my life. I've never told her about my life.
Yeah.
Anyway, at the end of the session, I felt a hand on my shoulder. And I grabbed that hand and then it just dissipated. And I was like, oh my god. And she was actually looking. I'm telling him about the medium experience.
Right.
And yeah, it was like, I was like, what the hell? Who was that? You know, sort of thing. But I'm guessing it was my mom putting her hand, saying, you know, everything's all right, sort of thing. Like, you know. But it was strange because she even looked up into that corner. And in part of the meeting, in part of the session as well, It wasn't anything outside, it wasn't anything inside. Oh, well, it was something inside the building we were at. But a flash of light. And we both looked over there and was like, saw it. Like inside the room. And was like, wow, did you see that? And she's like, yeah, I saw that. I'm like, whew. But the thing is, when she was telling me all this stuff, there was just so much, and a lot of it I didn't even understand. Because the fact that it was my mother coming through and telling me about, I can't remember the woman's name, but about a lady that she grew up with who taught her how to cook or something. It wasn't her mother, I think it was like an auntie or something like that. But apparently she might have passed away not long ago too. Maybe that's what the message was. I don't know. I think someone passed away in our family not long ago. Really, quite. It was Sharon's mum, I think. No. Sharon's grandma? Nan. Sharon's nana. Who's Sharon's nana? I don't know. That'd be. What? Well, Sharon's nana is not my nana. Because my nana on that side of the family dead years and years and years ago. I'll ask Mark. Mark will know. I'm just trying to finish the rest of my coffee. Have a chat with you guys. Going home. Ugh. Can't believe how sick I was last night. So sick. I felt so ill. I thought I was like gonna die. Oh, I'll tell you about the plans that they're gonna be doing to this house. So, on this side here, coming, that's all going. That's going to be all rebuilt at the back there. And the deck is moving forward and across a bit. There's going to be a bedroom on this side, and it's going to be lowered. There's going to be a bedroom on this side, and there's going to be a lounge room on this side. And I haven't yet, but I'm going to see if Mark will do a loft up the top of the bedroom. So, yeah, I'm not too sure. But I'm gonna see what he thinks. Because, what if I wanted to come down and visit? I wanna go up in the loft and be up there, you know? Instead of in the front of the house where he will have clients and all that sort of stuff if they do come over and, you know, discuss things, because his office is in the front. So, question, how do I get to Mudgee from Bateman's Bay? Probably bus it, most likely. Probably bus. Bus to Sydney to Mudgee maybe, or something, I don't know. Oh, I don't know if trains come out here. Not sure. I'll have to figure that out. There is a train station here, but I don't know. Anyway, it's time to go to the loo. It's time to finish this up. And it's time to get going really soon. So we will see you when we get home, I think. I'm not going to vlog anymore until we get home. I might do some road things, I don't know. Something like that. I do care. I really do. I just, my stomach's going, hey, I need to do shit. And on that note, I'll catch you guys later. Bye. Oh yeah, I forgot. So, I'm on Musical.ly and I'm on Flipagram. I don't know if Flipagram does it, but I know Musical.ly does it. Musical.ly has this thing where you can have one person doing one thing and then another person doing the same thing at the same time. So, the question is, but the thing is, Most of all, this stuff is pre-recorded music and I hate it. It's awful. Absolutely awful. Lip-syncing other people's music. No, I don't like it. But I'm asking any of you guys out there who do have Musical.ly, would you like to do a duet with me? Now, if you have to either sing, play guitar, music, whatever, record your bit, then I'll record my bit over yours, and we'll do what Musical.ly was meant to be used for, not lip-syncing other people's stuff, because that's what Musical.ly was invented for. It was for people who wanted to do duets with each other, show their talents, not lip-syncing their talents. Like, for fuck's sake, I remember this girl, I haven't seen her in a while, but she has the most awesomest voice. That's probably not even a word. She's got the most amazing voice and guitar skills. She wasn't playing guitar. She was playing ukulele skills. But she does all this lip syncing stuff. And it's like, I want to see you more. Do more of this than the lip syncing stuff. Do more what you're talented for, not this stuff. So that's what Musical.ly was all built for, to show your talent. Musical.ly, that's what it's meant for, anyway. So, Flippogram is pretty much the same thing, except it's more video stuff, dancing and singing and guitar and stuff like that. Just trying to show your talent, acting, doing skits and stuff, like attempting LA. Anyway, what's the time?
It's just gone 8 o'clock.
I'm gonna go
15 minutes.
Bathroom and all that.
Listerine is in there still.
Yeah, no, I need to do that before we go.
Just help me for a second. Hold this here. Okay, is it in?
Yep, she's in. And on that note, we'll see you guys later.
Oh my God. I don't wanna know, we're taking you home, I'm loving you so. I used to love you, no, I don't wanna know, no. Who's taking you home, I'm loving you so. The way I used to love you, oh, I don't wanna know. Wasted. And the more I drink, the more I think about you. Baby, every place I go reminds me of you. And every time I go out, yeah, I hear it from this one, hear it from that one, that you got someone new. Yeah. I see we don't believe it. Even in my head, listen to my bed, maybe I'm just a fool. What's your butt?
8726. This is the time Bella gets all like, because what's going on? What's going on?
Can you read? Is the number still there? No, I can't remember it again. Forgot already. 8176, I think, but I better check. Wait, shush. I'm here. Stop
laughing. You're such a big crybaby, Bella. Oh, bad breath. Oh. You need a Mentos. Jesus Christ. Any cereal? Really? Have you got the lid closed properly, like on the tank? Hit the petrol thing, it might be just stuck.
Oh, it's the car was locked. 8726, that's why. 8726. There we go.
And here we go. Where is he? She lost him. She can't see him. Aw, Bella, it's such a sook. You are. I'm here. Look at me. Can you not see me? Biggest sook on this planet.
Yeah.
And off we go.